Hello friends, I am Adyanand Tiwari and welcome to Gatematic channel. Okay, so please subscribe our channel and click on bell icon for further updates. So we have covered the three lectures on transmission line. Now this is the fourth lecture on the transmission line. Okay, so our next topic is methods to improve power transfer capability of transmission line. Okay, we want the maximum power across the sending end or the receiving end. So I am considering here the short transmission line. In short transmission line, only resistance and reactance are there. Okay, so but we neglect here resistance also. So this is transmission line reactance and this is the sending end voltage VS delta and this is receiving end voltage VR zero and their load is connected across this side. So what is the power? Now PS and PR are equal, that is equals to VS VR by XL into sine of delta. So now VS VR by XL into sine of delta. Delta is the angle of the sending end side voltage. Okay, now suppose this has angle delta 1 and this has angle delta 2. Agar VR ke paas mera delta 2 angle ho aur VS ke paas delta 1 angle ho, then the power equation will be PR equals to PS, that is equals to VS VR, that is magnitude of voltage sending end and receiving end voltage, line reactance and sine of delta 1 minus delta 2. So if delta 1 is higher and delta 2 is lower, then this value gives positive value and we know sending end direction for the generator is this side and receiving end this side. So always remember power flow from higher angle to the lower angle. Jahan par angle high hoga wahan se power transfer hoga lower angle ki taraf. So if delta 1 is high then delta 2 is low, so power transfer direction across jo hum maine dikhaya wo direction hoga. Now suppose delta 2 is higher. Okay, so if delta 2 is higher, the power direction is reversed of the previous case. Okay, so remember active power always from higher angle to lower angle. So now here, so VS, so now if angle is delta and 0, then PS and PR is equals to VS VR by XL into sine of delta. Now considered VR magnitude is equals to VS, that is equals to V. So if you see both magnitude voltage are same, then PR equals to PS, that is equals to V square by XL into sine of delta. So if you see this equation, we want maximum receiving end power, so PR is directly proportional to voltage square first case, PR inversely proportional to line reactance and PR is directly proportional to sine of delta. Okay, so this is the voltage, that is sending end voltage and receiving end voltage, both are equal. So if voltage is higher across the bus, then the receiving end power is maximum. If line reactance is minimum, then the receiving end power is maximum. Okay, and delta is the load angle between the voltage VS and VR. So if delta is higher, then we know sine delta is high. So if sine delta is high, PR is high. But delta we can't increase up to a certain level, because agar delta again increase hoga, then system become unstable. So we will study later. So three methods: by increasing voltage, by reducing line reactance, or by increasing the delta. Now next is advantages of higher value of VS, VS or V. Okay, so we have first seen PR is directly proportional to V square. That means if you increase the voltage, then receiving end power is more. Next advantage is, we know power equals to VI cos phi, that is I we can write it as P by V cos phi, and line loss is equals to I square into resistance, because only resistance consume active power. So if you put I square, ye I square main yahan par put karu, that is P by V cos phi square into R, that is P square into R by V square cos phi. That means line loss is inversely proportional to voltage square. Now we can say that agar line loss is, we want line loss minimum, then voltage should be maximum. So hum logo ne kya kiya tha, yahan par voltage increase kiya tha to get the maximum receiving end power. But we get another advantages when you increase the voltage level, the line loss is also reduced by inversely proportional to voltage square. So this is the second advantages of getting higher volt value of BS. Now next third advantage is, we know resistance is equals to rho L by A, where rho is the resistivity of material, L is the length of the wire, and A is the area of cross section. That means area, we can write it as rho L by R. Okay, now if you see this equation, line loss, so we can calculate R from this equation, that is R equals to line loss V square cos phi by P square. This is the R value. If you put this R value across this side, then this equation become rho L by R is, sorry, PL V square cos phi by P square. This P square is at the numerator. That means if you see, area of cross section is inversely proportional to voltage square. Now this is the third advantages of getting higher value. Agar V square, V ka value jitna jyada lenge, area of cross section requirement is less, that is inversely proportional to V square. If area of cross section is inversely proportional to voltage square, then that means we can say that volume of conductor is also inversely proportional to voltage square, because if you multiply area into length, you will get the volume, and length is constant, so directly proportional to 1 by V square. So from this point, yahan se hum decide kar sakte, that means if you increase the voltage level, then our material requirement is reduced, okay, minimized, but it has certain limit. You can't increase voltage up to ek limit ke baad uske upar nahi kar sakte, because we can have to take care about insulation also. Voltage increase karte jayenge and area of cross section reduce karte jayenge, but there is a problem with insulation, that's why there is a limit, okay. But generally, volume is inversely proportional to voltage square, line loss is inversely proportional to voltage square, and receiving and power is directly proportional to voltage square. Advantages of higher value, yahan 3 point ye remember karke rakhna hai. Now next, we want to reduce the XL, because PR is inversely proportional to XL. So if you reduce the XL, then we will get the PR as higher value. So there is certain method jisse hum kya kar sakte hain, XL ko reduce kar sakte hain. First method is by using parallel transmission line, okay. So first, if you see, this is the sending end and receiving end. So this is voltage as 1 angle delta, and this is 1 angle 0, and this reactance as J1, okay. So if you calculate maximum power, then 1 into 1 by X, that is equals to 1, because we are calculating maximum power, so there is no sin delta. Now next case, connect a second reactance of the same value, this is J1. Now this is the similar J1, and the voltage is 1 angle delta, and this side voltage is 1 angle 0. Now if you calculate maximum power, then voltage is 1 angle delta and 1 angle 0, that is magnitude is 1 into 1. If you solve this parallel path reactance, then this equivalent reactance will come as J 0.5, okay, per unit. That means this is reactance is 0.2, that will give you 2 per unit as maximum power, and here we are getting 1 per unit as maximum power. So in this case, if you consider this is as P2, this is as P1, then P2 is higher than P1. So our conclusion is, by using parallel transmission line, agar hum parallel transmission line use karte hai, then line reactance is reduced. That means if line reactance reduced, then maximum power is increased, okay. Now next, by using series capacitor, okay. Now same example, suppose this has magnitude 1 angle delta, and this is receiving end 1 angle 0, and line reactance is J1. So if you calculate P1, that is 1 into 1, and line reactance is 1, and sine of angle is delta, that will gives you sine delta. Now series capacitor, that means if you connect a capacitor between line, so So this is one angle delta, this is one angle zero. If this is J1 and capacitive reactance is always minus, so this is suppose minus J 0.5, so total equivalent line reactance is J1 minus 0.5J, that will gives you 0.5J. So if you calculate second case power, then voltage is Vs is 1 and receiving end voltage is 1 and line reactance is 0.5, angle is sine delta, that is 2 into sine delta. That means again we are getting P2 is more than P1. So by using series capacitor also we can transfer the, we can reduce the X equivalent, and if X is reduced then power hamara kya ho jayega, increase ho jayega. So this is the second method to reduce the XL. Okay, but it has certain limitation, capacitor is not used, because if you see this is inductance and capacitor, this is sending end side and this is receiving end side. Okay, suppose surge occur or fault occur at any point. Okay, so what happened, this capacitor start charging, this plus minus VC and capacitor start charging. So you see this adds the voltage and it cause the insulation failure. Okay, this capacitor voltage increase the voltage level and it cause the insulation failure. That's why it has certain limitation to use series capacitor. Now next method to reduce XL is by using bundled conductor. Okay, bundled conductor means this is a one conductor and another conductor are bundled together and between them distance is D. So we'll, there is an inductance come LA as 0.2 ln of D by 0.7788 R millihenry per kilometer. So this is come as inductance for A conductor and B conductor is same as. So we'll see this formula later when we calculate the inductance for different material. Okay, with us. So if you see in this formula, the effective radius of the conductor increases due to the bundled conductor. Effective radius is increases. That means if radius increases, then LA reduces, and we know XL equals to 2 pi FL. If L reduces, then XL reduces, and PR is inversely proportional to XL. That is, if XL reduces, then we can say that receiving end power is also increasing. So by using bundle conductor also the XL reduced and receiving end power is increased. Now next method to increase the power transfer capability, to vary the load angle, because PR is directly proportional to sine of delta. Okay, and load angle is the angular displacement of the rotor axis with respect to synchronously rotating reference stator axis. Okay, so delta load angle we'll see in the stability chapter. Okay, so if you increase the load angle, then power also increases, but delta we can't increase up to after a certain limit, because to in stability ka criteria aa jayega. So delta is generally between 30 to 45 degree to maintain the stability of the synchronous machine. So these are the method to get the maximum power at the receiving end side. So thank you for watching this video and I hope it will help you. So subscribe our channel for latest update and click on bell icon for further updates. Okay, so thank you.